Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the world and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on a cross, my burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art. How great thou art.
Welcome to First Baptist Church of Bemis. This Wednesday, I would like to share a devotion with you and for you that I pray will encourage your hearts. One of my favorite devotion books that I have leaned on through the years was written by David Jeremiah. The book is entitled Turning Points. You may have a copy of this devotion, but for several years I would read and reread many of his devotions. The other day I was looking at one of my favorite devotions in the book, And I remember David Jeremiah talking about a story that he read, and I'd like to share that with you today. Some years ago, musicians noted that errand boys in London all whistled out of tune. People were asking, "What's wrong? What's going on? Can they not hear that their whistle is out of tune?" Someone suggested that the bells of Westminster were slightly out of tune, and the boys did not know this. You see, the boys had copied their whistle according to the bells that were out of tune. Dear friends, you know this as well as I. Our world, our nation, our city, our homes, our schools, well, they're out of tune. Our world is going through uncharted waters, and if we're not careful, we will allow our spiritual hearts, our spiritual minds, to be out of tune in the way the world is out of tune. I suggest to you this Wednesday that we as believers in Jesus Christ, we don't have to be out of tune. Why? Because God's holy word offers us hope. I firmly believe in these unusual days, if we'll turn to God's holy word, we will be in tune. Do you remember the book of Joshua? You remember Joshua? What an awesome responsibility he had been given from the Lord to follow Moses. In Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, a very familiar verse, it reads, "Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest." Did you hear that carefully? When I read that, it helps my heart and my mind be in tune with the Holy Spirit. We're watching the media, we're listening to our radios, we're reading our newspapers, and friend, there's a lot of media that seems to be out of tune. And I suggest to you today that if we will listen to God's holy word and take comfort to be strong in the Lord, our spiritual whistle will be in tune with the Holy Spirit. Today, I firmly believe and suggest to you today that our world will be back in tune soon. Restoration will come. Healing will come. Why? Because I firmly believe that God is hearing the prayers of His people, His children, all over the world. Friend, we can't give up. We've got to continue to offer our prayers up to the Father. And in His perfect timing, the Lord will bring our life of normal back again. But until then, friend, I encourage you, stay in tune with the Holy Spirit. Stay in tune with your Bible study. Stay in tune with other believers through telephone or through calling or texting. Stay in tune with the things that we know are holy. And friend, we will keep our life in tune. Also, let me encourage you, we as a church staff want to continue to keep your protection as our ultimate goal. Our services for this Wednesday, March the 25th, our Sunday services for March the 29th have been postponed. Why? Because we want to protect you and we want your health to be well. Yes, we will soon. In God's time, we will come again on Wednesday and come again on Sunday. But until then, our Wednesday services and our Sunday services have been postponed. Again, please watch us this coming Sunday at 10 o'clock of the hour. And again, please, let me encourage you. If you're at home today and you're watching this, whether you are a member or not, doesn't matter. I want you to call the number on the screen, our church number, We are here for you Monday through Thursday. Please call us. A staff member will be here to pick up the phone, talk to you, pray with you. You might be saying, Pastor, I'm not a member of First Baptist. I'm lonely. I'm afraid. I need to hear a prayer. I need to hear someone read the scriptures. Friend, do you know that that is an honor? Whether you're a member or whether you're not, you pick up that phone. And it'll only take just a minute or two to reach out to you and to offer you a word of hope. You might be saying, Pastor, my life is out of tune. I'm not for sure about my next meal. I'm not for sure, Pastor, about tomorrow. And I need just to know that God is in control. Friend, call. I personally would like to talk with you, and of course our other staff members would as well. But friend, I want to encourage you. God is still in control. God is watching over this situation all over the world. And I want to encourage you. Read your Bible every day. Pray to God every day. And through these wonderful opportunities of spending more time with God, our hearts will be in tune with the Holy Spirit. Well, thank you for being with us today. I hope that this word will just lift you up. And as always, I want you to know, I always want you to hear this and tuck this in your heart. Jesus does love you. Now, before we go, I want to lead you in a word of prayer. Would you pray with me right where you are? Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the gift of another day. We thank you, Father, that through reading your word, praying, spending time with you, our hearts will forever be in tune with the Holy Spirit. Father, our world needs a miracle. Father, we need a fresh touch of the Holy Spirit. And Father, I am praying as well as a host of many countless other believers are praying that through this, a sweeping revival will happen all over the world. Father, be with our president. Give him wisdom. Give him strength. Be with all of those, Father, who are trying daily to find a vaccine for this virus. Father, be with our children while they're out of school. Be with the parents. Father, be with the churches. Be with our missionaries around the world. Be with those who are in the hospital. Be with the doctors and nurses. And Father, be with those who are protecting our cities all over the world. Father, we thank you for this good day. Bless those who are watching. And I encourage those who need a word of hope to call us, that we might pray and read your word to them. Father, we thank you, we love you, and we know without a doubt that you're in control. We thank you, Father. In Christ's name we pray, and amen. God bless you, and have a good day.